This video belongs to a series with a complete example in which I show how I bring a Blender model to Unity and some extra information about shortcuts and other things that I take into account. In the corner, I leave you the link to the introduction where I show the content of each video so you can watch the complete series or choose the video with the topic you need. In this video, we're gonna apply materials to the 3D model we made in the previous one. I leave it in the corner in case you wanna watch it. So let's start changing the rendering mode. Pressing C allows me to choose how to visualize the scene. Currently, we are in the solid mode. In the wireframe mode, we only see the vertices, edges, but not the faces. In the material preview, we see the materials and how they are applied. This mode is gonna be useful for this video. In this case, our model doesn't have any material yet, so now we are seeing the model completely white. In the rendered mode, in addition to the material mode, we have environment and lighting. Notice that the model has some sort of color, but this color is due only to the lights, the mix of these lights, which have a certain color, and also this light over here, which is like a moon giving a dim light on the model. But this model doesn't have any material applied, so we're gonna start from there. Let's go to the material preview. By the way, in Blender, pretty much everything is contextual. Notice that if I have the mouse cursor here and press C, nothing happens, the same here. But instead, if the cursor is located in the 3D viewport and then press Z, now I get this menu. So let's select the model and come here to the materials tab. This window is also contextual. And for example, if I select the light, here the tabs change because it's a different object that has other properties. The same for the camera, notice that here now we have a little camera icon that wasn't there before. Anyways, select the model and go here to the materials part. Here we will create a new material. Let's name it ground. So now we have a material with a default shader. A shader is like some code that tells the graphic card how to render the faces of the model. Blender's default shader is called Principle BSDF. Here we can choose for example the color. Let's go to the material preview mode. Notice that here, as we created a material and there was no material before, the new material was applied to the whole model, which is fine. We are gonna create new materials and select which faces we want for each material. Here we have several options. For example, we can change the metallic property, the roughness, to configure how much the material reflects the environment light. But we aren't gonna stop here because a very few of these properties are gonna be exported to Unity, because Unity doesn't have the principal VSDF shader. Unity has the standard shader and any other shader that we may code or download. So from now on, keep in mind that the materials that we export will have to be configured in Unity. But here in Blender, we need to set up how the materials will be distributed. So now let's create a new material here by clicking on the plus sign and then in new. Let's name it concrete and choose the color. So now, how do we assign the concrete material to these faces? Well, to begin, we select the object and enter in the edit mode. Then go to the faces mode and we are gonna select the faces to which we want to apply the material. A quick way to select face loops is pressing left alt and clicking on a face and then its neighbor several times until it works. It's a mystery for me how this works, but I know that trying like this, making this trick between one face and another, Blender eventually understands that the loop I want to select is this one. Okay, now I click on this button to assign the material. As we can see, these faces are shown in a different color. I'm gonna select these other faces and apply the same material to them. Now we're gonna create a new material, which will be for the metal parts. We choose the color, set the metallic parameter to 1, and now we're gonna apply it to the faces of the model. It's the same process as before. Select the faces and assign the material. Notice once again how the appearance of the model changes. Here we could set, for example, a low roughness, but as I said, we will not see most of these properties automatically in Unity. So let's create the last material for the light. Write a name, choose a base color and an emission color down here. Assign the material to the model just like before. And now, notice that if I enter in the rendering mode, it looks like this. You can even add post-processing effects, for example bloom, ambient occlusion, screen space reflection, but once again, here in Blender it looks great, but in order to have post-processing effects in Unity, you will have to import some package or code these effects. So, we already have the model with all the materials applied. In the next video, we're gonna see how to make the UV mapping and apply textures. I'm gonna leave it in the final screen. I hope you found this video useful and see you in the next video. Bye!